Hello friends, keeping in mind everybody's time, we have started our podcast audiobook series. The benefit of our podcast series is that you can listen it anytime during driving, walking, cooking, and even at your leisure time. Almighty has created human being like a plain paper. Human being has to put in struggle to write on that blank paper. This writing leads to human evolution. Human evolution takes shape based on knowledge learned, skill acquired, and spirit of motivation developed, and it can only be changed by our habits. Today I will present you the second part of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. So let's start. Self-awareness and ability to think about the thought process is only activated in humans. Animals don't possess this ability. This is the reason why man has dominion over all things in the world. Our behavior is a function of our decisions, not our conditions. If we dissect responsibility, it will be responsible and ability. It means ability to choose your response. So, here we go with the first habit from 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, and that is be proactive. Highly proactive people recognize and understand responsibility. They do not blame circumstances, conditions, or conditioning for their behavior. Their behavior is a product of their own conscious choice, and it is based on values. As Eleanor Roosevelt told that, no one can hurt you without your consent. Our basic nature is to act and not to be acted upon. Proactivity is part of human nature, and we can say in some human being, the proactive muscles may be dormant, but they are always present. Let me explain you how reactive people and proactive people behave. Reactive people focus their efforts in the circle of concern. They focus on the weakness of other people, the problem in the environment, and the circumstances over which they have no control. Their negative energy causes their circle of influence to shrink. On the other hand, proactive people focus their efforts in the circle of influence. They work on the things they can do something about. The nature of their energy is positive, enlarging, and magnifying, causing their circle of influence to increase. Generally, the problem we face, it's fall in 3 categories. First is direct control, the problem which involves our own behavior. Second is indirect control, the problem involving from others' behavior. And the third is no control, problem we can do nothing about it, such as our past and situational realities. But as long as we are working in our circle of concern, we empower the things within it to control us. There are some people who interpret proactive to mean aggressive and insensitive, but that isn't the case at all. Proactive people are smart, they are value driven, they read realities, and they know what's needed. Example: Gandhiji is a very good example of proactive. He focuses in expanding his circle of influence even though he had no office and no political position. He does all this through compassion, courage, fasting, and more persuasion, and eventually brought England to its knees. In this book, author had explored his experience during his speech. Author was giving speech on the subject of proactivity, and in the middle of the speech, a woman suddenly stood up and started sharing her feelings excitedly. The hall was packed with large audience, so everybody turned and looked at her. Getting everybody's attention, she felt embarrassed, and without completing her words, she sat down. But during my complete speech, I observed her activities many times. I noticed that she seemed so happy and excited to share her experiences, and eventually she started talking to the person around her. During break, I approached to the lady and told what she wants to share. She replied that, "I am a full-time nurse to the most miserable and ungrateful man. Whatever I do, he never appreciates. He hardly even acknowledges me, always finding faults whatever I do. The man has made my life miserable. I often take my frustration to my home and family. I was so fascinated with your statement that nobody can hurt you without your permission. And this statement has changed my thought process. I feel that I am free. I am out of the prison. So from today onwards, nobody will control me." It's not what happens to us, but our response to what happens to us that hurts us. Of course, things can hurt us physically or emotionally and can cause sorrow. But our character, our basic identity, doesn't have to be hurt at all. We are responsible for our own effectiveness, for our own happiness, and ultimately, I would say, for most of our circumstances. This is the second part of the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Next part we will upload in coming Sunday. If you like the video, please press like button, share to your friends and families, comment which part of the podcast you liked it, do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for the future updates and notification. Thanks for patience.